Okay, how about the lighter side of enduring all of this cold weather? Many of us are feeling the sting of this record-breaking cold, but Paula Tutman found that a colony of local bees have a lot they can teach us on surviving the winter.
I'm at Detroit Hive, where there are obviously some very valuable lessons that humans can learn from honeybees on how to be warm and stay warm.
Yeah, we can head right in.
Believe it. It is a bitter record-breaking cold, and that's before the wind chill. But in order to be warm, don't think of ways to behave. Think of ways to beehive.
So one great thing about snow is that it's a natural insulator, and it protects a lot of that wind chill from those bees that you see in those hives.
At Detroit Hives, the bees are doing just fine. Mother Nature has uniquely equipped the honeybees to survive.
They cluster together just like us. When we get really cold, okay, we get closer together and we vibrate like this. They're shivering the same way, but they're creating friction, and they're able to maintain a temperature of 95 degrees inside those hives.
What you're looking at is an infrared image of one of the hives. With the efficiency of bees, who instead of spinning honey at this very moment, are spinning heat. Co-founder and executive director of Detroit Hives, Timothy Paul, says the fact of the matter is humans can learn a lot from bees when it comes to surviving the winter.
Definitely working together, definitely using each other, working with each other, to stay warm. They work as a super organism. Everybody works together for the best of the hive. Everyone has a job to play in their environment within the community, and they work all good for the hive. Making sure you prepare in advance. You can definitely use each other to stay warm. Around this time, get close to someone and stay warm.
Bees believe in being proactive, insulating their hives to keep cold air out and warm air in.
They collect propolis from the tree sap. From trees. When a tree gets hurt, it secretes a sap, and they collect that and they use it to seal up those hives.
The summer months, they literally work themselves to death with a maximum lifespan of about 6 weeks. But in the cold, other than keeping the queen bee warm and the hive clean, there's little else to do. So they actually live months instead of weeks. Those that don't survive are pushed from the hive by undertaker bees. No dead space allowed. They are singularly focused on the queen's warmth and comfort.
You know, there's a lot of discussion going on today about whether or not to turn your thermostat down to 65. I can tell you this, while you're turning your thermostat down, these guys have turned it up to a toasty 95 degrees. Paula Tutman, Local 4.